personally, I'm very happy that he's able to come today and willing to speak about his own personal experiences. So please give Robert a very warm welcome.
I started medical marijuana almost 2 years ago because of my chronic pain. I was on, at the time before I started marijuana, I was on 5 prescriptions, oxys, 2, 3 depression pills, and I was a zombie.
Yeah.
I was doing nothing. But back then, when I got my license, there was not too much around that. Like, I looked at the internet and videos, and there was not like clinics back then 2 years ago. Like, you had to go to Toronto. You had to go somewhere else. There was nothing around. So I finally found, like, I got, and my injury was done back in 2007. I got injured at work.
Oh, and God.
It went all downhill, especially when I got injections done in pain management. The first injection, that made it worse. My condition went downhill. And like in September of 2008, I started pain management. The 3 injections of the freezing to see if it would work. But the first injection, it didn't work. I had a bad reaction to it. For 3 days, I couldn't get out of my bed. I couldn't walk. I couldn't stand. I was in that much pain. Like, I was on the fentanyl patch. Oxys. Bacopol. And another medication that he brought up. But that medication, I ended up in the hospital for a week because I was puking blood. Going up blood. Now I can have that medication. And then, like, March of 2011, I even had back surgery. I tried everything to, I was hoping, to relieve the pain. Because my pain level when I first got injured was managed. Once I got the injections, my pain level went from being 5 to 10. 5 if I do nothing. 10 if I just did a little bit, I was in severe pain. And then in 2010, I went to my family doctors to get the forms done for the old license. And my family doctor said, no, there's no medical benefit. So I went back and did nothing. And I started trying to look on the internet, find a clinic. And it took me until 2015 that I found a doctor on the internet to do the paperwork. My first order was in August of 2015. And I smoked it because I didn't have no clinic to help me, what to do, nothing, so I just smoked it. After 3 days of this smoking, and it was, I bought 3 different strains, and like, one strain was a mix of 50-50, another one was high CBD, and another one just a little bit lower CBD, but higher THC. I tried all those ones, but every time I found an improvement was the high CBD. So after 3 days, my mornings were starting to improve. Like, when I was getting out of bed, I couldn't for a bit because of the stiffness. Once I got the high CBD, tried smoking it, my mornings were getting better. Then after that, I went and got a little vapor thing. I was vaping. And then after a week of that, I got my supplies together. I started making my own capsules. I was getting the drawing. activating, and I became the high CBD. I started out with 12% CBD and 0.9% THC. Now I take 18% CBD, 1.5 THC, but when I activate in the oven, the THC is burned off. I'm just on high CBD. And December 2015, I took my last pharma pill for my prescription for my injury. I used to, 2 years ago, before I even started with marijuana, I was using a walker. I was bent over. My leg was stiff. I was in bed almost 18 hours a day because I didn't want to do nothing. I was a zombie. Mm-hmm. I couldn't do anything. Pain was, every time I tried to do something, pain was unmet. Like, I just didn't want to do nothing. But once I found out, like, I tried, I thought it was a joke, CBD. But once I tried it, I couldn't believe it. And then in 2016, I'd seen my family doctor. He signs the papers now for me because he can't argue the point that, because when you were going to the office in a walker, bent over, can't stand up straight, severe pain, and you tried all the medication, every different one, and all the other procedures, and nothing works. And then you go in, and he can't argue, he goes, you're not taking nothing no more for your injury, except capsule 3 times a day. I take these capsules 3 times a day, I make my own. I buy the dry weed, and I activate it up, and I make all my capsules. And then I get a 50-50 blend, and I make my own cream I rub on my back. And I activate it on the stove with coconut oil. Mm-hmm. And it's the best thing. Coconut oil is the best thing for the skin. And since I do the two things, I just don't. I'm just taking it step by step. But more barely, the other doctor was saying that you got the cannabinoids in your system. But it took me about 4 months to get out of pharma. It took me another 6 months to, I was able to walk a little bit better. Like, it's the best thing I found. And like, it doesn't have no THC. I'm more uplifted now than before. Before, I didn't want to do nothing when I was on pharma. I just was a zombie. Now I'm all uplifted. I go out, I can go out no problems, enjoy life, and pain free.
How do you start to know what is, it took you 2 months to figure out what is good for you or what gives you relief? So from here to good relief, what process and how you can put this thing together?
When I started smoking,
yes.
I had the different strains. I tried the one. And with smoking, you get that relief right away. And I did, every time I was doing it, every time I did this high CBDs, I smoked it, that's where I felt more relief. So I decided to leave the other ones alone. Then in September 5th, I got all my stuff together in 2015. I went out and bought everything to make my capsules. And all the samples I had, I put all the stuff together to make the capsules. And then I just kept on doing the capsule. And then I found out, I started first at 12% CBD, and now I'm at 18%. I found out the higher the CBD, the better. Like, I'm almost pain-free. I get discomfort when I do this or this, different things. But now, with the high CBD, I'm almost pain-free. And my life went from 180 degrees compared to 2 years ago. Yeah, and off all the pharma for my injury. Per 50 capsules. the buds and put it in water with coconut oil and let it simmer on the stove, I think it's 180 for 2 to 3 hours. Because the coconut oil gets the oil from the marijuana, and you use the cheesecloth to strain it. Then you have to separate the water from the oil. And after that, I put the oil in a double boiler, and then I put a little bit of beeswax in it with emu oil and mix it up, and then you put it in the fridge, and that's, I make the cream like that. A lot of the stuff at the time wasn't much out, but YouTube videos, internet search groups, that's all I learned, because I didn't have nobody, I didn't have a clinic to tell me how to do it or how much. When I found the doctor to do it, he just told me, 2 grams a day, there's your papers. And when I started, about a week and a half after doing it, and I was on the beat, I went to see my counselor and two of the secretaries in my doctor's office. They couldn't believe the improvements, this being on it a week and a half. And so I didn't tell my doctor yet because I was still a little bit nervous because he told me no meds that day. So I didn't want to tell him yet.
Maybe you can give a very short recipe to...
I got the papers here for it. I got some papers here that I made up. I could show them. And yeah, I got it here, I can thank her. And you can do it how you figure out when you want to do it.
Question back
here. Do you bake before you put them in the capsules?
I put in the oven, like I have a mason jar, and I get about 2 ounces. I put in the oven for 320 for 40 minutes. That activates the CBD. But that burns off the THC. After the oven, I let it sit for the day, like overnight. The next day, I get a coffee grinder, I grind it, then I get a swift light, and then clean it, like the screen to clean it. Once it's all clean, because there's still little sticks, all that, so you want to clean it out, the powder. Once the powder's done, I weigh out how much to put in the capsules. Like, at the time, it was like 12, 13 grams I started. I do now 15 grams, I weigh out, and then from 15 grams to 50 capsules. And it worked out being 0.30 grams per capsule.
Another question, Dr.
Yeah?
Russ, I love Dr.